Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we are going to discuss about the rules of IUPAC nomenclature of alkenes. So what are the rules of that, and let us see it one by one with an example. So now discussing about the rules of the IUPAC nomenclature of alkenes, starting with the first point, that is, we have to select the longest continuous chain of carbon atom containing double bond. So that is the main thing that we have to discuss. Just like alkane that we have did in our previous chapter, that is in alkane, we have also learned about the rules of IUPAC nomenclature of alkane, and now here we are going to study about the rules of IUPAC nomenclature of alkene. So in this case, the main thing that we should consider is we should consider the carbon-carbon double bond. So we have to select the longest chain that should contains at least all the carbon-carbon double bonds that have been present, or at least one carbon-carbon double bond. Let me give you an example of that. Suppose if we have, I'm just drawing a skeleton of the carbon atoms and not going to draw the hydrogen atom. So suppose this is the molecule in terms of an alkane that we have. And suppose if I have added over here a double bond, so this is the longest chain that we could consider, that this would be the longest chain. Suppose in any case, suppose if a branching starts, so suppose if this is the one where branching starts, so what would be the longest chain? The longest chain would be, that is, we could take it as this one. This one would be the longest chain. Or either we could take the longest chain as this one. But in both the cases, that what we are considering is, we are considering that it should be longest chain as well as it should contain at least carbon-carbon double bond. So in this case, suppose if I have introduced in this manner also, when it comes to an alkene, suppose if we have introduced, suppose in this manner, suppose the chain is in this manner, so what would be the longest chain? In terms of alkane, we could say that the longest chain would be this one, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 is the carbon atom that we should consider when it comes to an alkane. But this is not an alkane, because here we can see that carbon-carbon double bond is also been present in the overall molecule. That is the reason we will select the longest chain in such a manner that that chain should contain at least one carbon-carbon double bond. So looking at this structure, suppose if this structure that we have, so therefore the longest chain will be, and moreover it should contain the carbon-carbon double bond. So the longest chain along with the carbon-carbon double bond would be this one. So this is the longest chain that consists of one carbon-carbon double bond, making the total carbon of atom in the parent chain is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 carbon atoms are present in the longest chain, and carbon-carbon double bond is there, so making this to be called as an alkene. So this is the first one that we have talked about, and here also we have studied that we should consider only that carbon-carbon long chain which consists of carbon-carbon double bond when it comes to alkene. So now let us move on to the second point of the second rule that we are going to study in this case. That is, the number, we have to number the carbon atoms from the end nearest to the double bond. So this is the one that we are going to talk about. So in alkene also, where we have data, we have to number in such a manner that the branching should get the lowest number. And meanwhile, in case of alkene, we have to consider the double bond. If the double bond is very close to the end, then we have to number the carbon atom from that end, where we could see that the carbon-carbon double bond should get a least number. So this is the example that I am going to talk about. The same molecule that we have, skeleton that we have drawn over here. And in this case, what we have to do is we have to number. So ultimately, we have got to know that this overall parent chain consists of 8 carbon atoms. But the main thing is about numbering. So the numbering will be done from which end? That is the main concern that we are going to talk about. So talking about this chain, that is, I could consider this to be the first, or either I could consider this to be the first. So let us consider, suppose if this would be the first carbon atom or while numbering. So therefore this one would be the first, second, third, fourth, fifth. And here we could see that at fifth position, we could receive a carbon-carbon double bond. So from 5th carbon atom, we could say receive carbon-carbon double bond. Then 6, 7 and 8. So this is the first option that we have made, that while numbering from lower end to upper end, that is what you observe in your screen. But what if we have numbered from this end? That is, suppose this is 1, 2, 3, 4. So as you could see that double bond is present between carbon number 3 and carbon number 4. And since the double bond is arising, or we could see that the double bond is starting while numbering, while it's starting from carbon number 3. So therefore, we should prefer this as the numbering one. So therefore, this should be the preference of the number, or this one should be the sequence where we would write this in the carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. The reason behind that we have numbered it from this, that is, we could see that the carbon number or carbon-carbon double bond is very near to this end and not to this end. That's the reason the numbering rule is also playing a very important role, and that is the rule of the IUPAC nomenclature of alkene. So these are the two that we have studied about. So now let us move on to the next, and this is the rules. These are the rules that we have to keep in our mind while naming or while giving a nomenclature to an alkane structure, which has been given to us in terms of an alkane or in terms of an alkene. So that's the reason we have to keep in our mind, because that plays a very important role. Now let us move on to the third and the fourth rule of that. Yes. So what we have to do is, we have to name the alkene, and since the name of the alkene is obtained by replacing ANE by ENE, and this ANE is of an alkene. So what we have to do is, if the hydrocarbon consists of a carbon-carbon single bond, or if the overall skeleton of, in that case we have drawn. So in that case, suppose if it is an alkane, so we know that when it is an alkane, the name will end with ANE, that is this one. But if it is an containing a double bond, then obviously it is an alkene, and that's the reason that the that is the suffix will end with the name ENE. So let me give you an example. So I'll consider the same example. So as you know that it is of basically 8 carbon atoms, and 8 carbon atoms in terms of an alkane or in terms of an saturated hydrocarbon, if you would say, then the name of that would be octane. But this is not an alkane, this is an alkene, and we can see that there is a carbon-carbon double bond in the overall molecule. And that's the reason that the name of this would be octene. The word ANE is being replaced by ENE, making this to be called as an alkene. So this is the third rule that we have studied, and that says that we have to name the alkene by replacing the word ANE of alkane by ENE. Now, let us move on further. The further thing is, the locate number indicating the position of double bond is written immediately before the suffix ENA. The locate number, what is that? What is the locate? Means basically the location of the carbon-carbon double bond, or you could see the number from which the double bond starts. So, let me give you an example of this one, that is, which represents the position of the carbon-carbon double bond. So in this case, suppose if we are going to name, or if we are going to nomenclate a particular alkene, a structure of an alkene, and in this case what we could see is the carbon-carbon double bond starts from the third carbon atom, making this to give the locate or the number of the carbon atom to be 3. And this 3 will represent the position of the carbon-carbon double bond. And that's the reason, suppose if I have to name this thing, and suppose if I am not considering the groups, suppose in general case, suppose if I am naming it when it comes to an octene. So in this case, I could see that the carbon-carbon double bond is present between carbon 3 and carbon 4, making this to be called as oct-3-E. So the word E and E, that is what we know as E, that is the suffix. So what we have to do is, we have to add a number before the word E and E. And this number will represent what? Yes, this number will represent the position or the location of the carbon-carbon double bond from which it has been originating, or from which carbon it has been forming a double bond. So that is the reason the name of this would be oct-3-ene, making an indication that the double bond starts from the carbon number 3. And that is the thing that we are going to study, and we have studied about. So these are the rules that we have studied, and this is what we have to keep in our mind. Again, I am telling you, we have to keep this in our mind so as to represent the IUPAC nomenclature. So now, let us move on with the further one. So this is the fourth one that we have studied about, and let us understand the fifth or more IUPAC rules for alkene. So this one says that it is simply like the alkene. Let me relate this one, but first of all, read this one. That is, if the double bond is equidistant from the two end, then number the carbon atom from that end which is nearer to the first branching. So let me explain this with an example, and we come back again here so as to express in a more widely and more deeply about how we have understood this fifth point. Suppose if I am talking about an example like this one. Suppose this is an example, and this is obviously an alkene, because as in this case we can see that carbon-carbon double bond is being present here. And talking about the Longestine, yes, we could select the Longestine in this manner, where the Longestine would be considering of four carbon atoms. So this is the one which I can consider as four carbon atoms that are present in the Longestine, and yes, moreover, you could see carbon-carbon double bond. Either I could have taken this as the Longestine also, as you could see. And the same that we have studied in the IUPAC Nomenclature, but the of alkene. But now in this case, the carbon-carbon double bond is also the main consideration. So this is what we have done. So the first job has been done by selecting the Longestine, continuous Longestine of a carbon atom. And the main thing is now numbering. So the numbering can be done in either ways. For example, if I number it from this case, that is carbon number one, this is carbon number two. So in carbon number two, what I could see is double bond starts. If I number it from left to right in this sequence, and so what if I number it from right to left in this case, that is 1, 2. Again, the thing is, I'm getting a carbon-carbon double bond on the position number two or on the carbon number two. So the double bond is equidistant from both the end. So we'll prefer which of the end. That is the main thing that we are going to learn, and that we have learned. That is, we will number it from that end where we could receive branching more nearer to that end. So in this case, suppose if I number it in this manner or in from this side, so therefore this one would be the first, second, in eventually in both the cases we would get second, but in third I am getting a branch. So at third carbon atom the branching starts. But if I number it from here, that is, if this is the carbon number one, so at second carbon the branching starts, making this to be followed by the IUPAC nomenclature rule of alkene. That's the reason what we are going to prefer is we are going to prefer this to be the first carbon atom when it comes to the sequencing, or when it comes to the numbering of the carbon atom of the longest chain. This one the first, this is the second, third, and this is the fourth. So now this is the correct sequence for giving the number. So this is what we have got to learn by the fifth IUPAC nomenclature. So let us learn it again and let us come it back. So the thing is, if the double bond is equidistant from two ends, the number we have to number the carbon atom from that end which is nearer to the first branching. So here it is what we have done. So in both the cases, it was equidistant. The double bond was equidistant from both the ends, and but we have preferred. From that end where we would receive the carbon-carbon double bond to get a or very nearer to the end. So that is all. But in this case what we have preferred is, we have preferred from that side where we could receive the carbon-carbon branching, as you could see, at a get a lower number, and it is very nearer to a particular end. So this is the one that we have preferred. Very easy to understand. So now let us move on with the next rule. So the next rule says that depending upon the number of double bonds in the parent chain, di, tri, etc. is used before ene. So that is the main thing that I am going to talk about. Because as you know that alkene is not only the one which consists of only one carbon-carbon double bond. It could consist of multiple carbon-carbon double bonds. Let me give you an example. Suppose if we have this is an alkene that we have, and we could see that there is not only one carbon atom, one carbon-carbon double bond atom, as you could see over here, but yes, there are multiple, you could see two carbon-carbon double bond over here. So now, the thing is numbering. So this is not the rule 6, but let us prefer in that sequence of the rules that we have studied. So this is the first thing that we have selected is the elongation that consists of carbon-carbon double bond, and now the first thing that we are going to do in the next one is to number it. But can we number it from here? No, we cannot number it from here. The reason behind that is, suppose in the rules also we have studied that we have to number from that end where we would receive the carbon-carbon double bond much more near to that end. So that's the reason we will number it from here. So therefore this is going to be the first, second, third, fourth and fifth. So this consists of 5 carbon atoms, making this to be called as pentane when it comes to an alkane. But it is not an alkane, this is an alkene, so making this to be called as pentene. But this is not also having a carbon-carbon, only one carbon-carbon single bond. It has basically 2 carbon-carbon double bonds, as I'm saying. As it consists of one carbon-carbon double bond, it consists of 2 carbon-carbon double bonds. So now, so suppose if it is a pentene, so I would write it in this way, that is pentene. But this work is not being done yet. The reason behind that is I have not mentioned the number from where the carbon-carbon double bond starts. So that is the reason that I would write it in this way. That is, I would write it in pent, that is one, and on second position also I could see two. E. So is that can be called as pent 1, 2 E? I am missing something. And what is that? Let me talk to you about that. Which is one which has been cleared in this one. That is, depending upon the number of double bonds in the parent chain, di, tri, etc. is being used before E. So in this case, basically, what I am saying is, I am seeing 2 carbon-carbon double bonds. That is, here I could see carbon-carbon double bond, and here I could see carbon-carbon double bond. Since in this case, basically, 2 carbon-carbon double bonds are present, so that's the reason I would write it di. So that is the reason the suffix, before the suffix I should immediately write diene. This di represents 2 carbon-carbon double bond that are present in the molecule that I have drawn over here. But is this sufficient so? No. There is another rule that we have to follow, and that is the most important rule, and that is the thing that we should not miss out in IUPAC nomenclature. The reason behind that is, it is something unique, and let's talk about that also. So the 7th point says that this is what we know already up to here, and let us learn it again. That is, if more than one double bond is present, the prefix di, tri, etc. are being used before ene that we have written over here in terms of an example that we have to do. And thing is not over done yet. And the letter A is added after the prefix for the number of carbon atoms. Prefix for the number of carbon atoms. This is what. The total number of carbon atoms that are present in a longish chain is basically 5, and this 5 carbon atoms make this to be called as pentane, or we could call it in terms of an alkene, it is known as pentane. But in this case, what we know that is in terms of alkene, we have wrote it as pent. But the rule that is mentioned over here, that is the lay, that is the letter A is being added after the prefix. So this is the prefix that we have written over here, named as pent. But I could see that there are not only one carbon-carbon double bond, but there are more carbon-carbon double bonds, making this to be having a 2 carbon-carbon double bonds, 2 or 3 or whatever it would have. So therefore, we will name this as penta. This A would be added after the prefix, that is pent. So therefore, the name of this would be penta 1,2-diene. Suppose if we have an alkene like octene, and in this case, suppose if we have 3 carbon-carbon double bonds, and suppose if they are arranged in this one, that is 1, 2, 3, or it starts from the carbon number 1, it starts from carbon number 2, and it is between carbon number 3 and 4. So in that case, the name of that would be not oct 1, 2, 3, E, or triene. It would be in this manner, octa 1,2,3, triene. So that would be the name of the alkene, where that A after the prefix that we have used in terms of this example that I have made of octane. So the oct will have an alphabet A after it, which we call as octa 1,2,3 triene. So this was the thing that I wanted to explain. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood the IUPAC nomenclature of alkene very much in a very good way. So share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much.